Welcome to Insights, and thanks for tuning in once again. Today we're located at 3,000 meters above sea level with the beautiful backdrop of the Geislachkogel insertion at the Ice Cube. But of course, I don't want to start the show by myself. And now I'm very happy to have the managing director of the Doppelmayr Group, Thomas Pichler, by my side. Hello, Thomas.
Hi, Karina. So good to have you anchoring Insights once again. Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome. It's great to have you with us. It's a pleasure to be able to give you some insights once again into our latest projects around the world. Today we will be looking at technical innovations and first and foremost at very special architecture. Our main topic today is ropeways and architecture. Why? Because ropeways are not just masterpieces of technology. They are always infrastructure premises that stand out by virtue of their location alone, whether it's at the foot of a mountain or at its very summit, or set against a breathtaking natural backdrop or embedded in a landscape worthy of protection. In towns and cities all around the world, our ropeways are to be found in central location, where they shape the cityscape. Which begs the question, how do we design these stations and these buildings architecturally? Well, in such a way that they have a positive and sustainable effect. Architecture defines our environment, sometimes it's spectacular, and then it also has that wow effect, like up here on the Geislachkogel, at the Ice Cube, and at the 007 elements. At other times, it blends elegantly into the landscape or the city. That's when it's the architecture's restraint that makes an impact. Together with our clients, we have realized some tremendous projects. I'm sure you will be fascinated by how diverse the design and the appearance of ropeway stations can be, both inside and out. Our example shows that architecture places completely new emphasis in terms of planning, design, and function. This sort of architecture is one to marvel at. It makes you want to meet up with others, to get on board, to go for a ride, and above all, come back time and time again. Let yourself be inspired.
And we would love to be inspired, of course. And we'll begin with an architectural specialty in your home. All I can say is this: it's sparkling, mystical, and legendary.
Here in South Tyrol, we tell the tale of King Loren, who is said to have ruled over a people of dwarves from his underground crystal palaces ages ago.
Hello, Florian. It's great to meet you after all the years we have spent together as part of the Ski World Cup. I was there as a presenter when you scored your biggest success, third place in Alta Badia. And today, I get to visit you in the Rosengarten area, the place you call home.
Yeah, Stefan, herzlich willkommen.
Yes, welcome, Stefan. It's a pleasure to have you here in the kingdom of King Loren, beneath these magnificent rock faces.
Aber auch ganz in der Nähe von
and close to King Loren's secret underground treasure chamber. Take a look. It's down there.
That's unbelievable. The gondola disappears right into the mountain.
Ganz genau.
Exactly. But I'd say let's get inside and have a closer look.
Mr. Choll, I am really impressed by this extraordinary top station. How did you come up with the idea of literally building this station into the mountain?
We are here in one of the most magnificent regions of South Tyrol, with the Rosengarten behind us, the Latemar, Schlern, and exceptional views over all of South Tyrol, almost uninterrupted. That's something very, very rare for us too. And the Rosengarten, which has always excited people, especially because of the Loden legend, which is ever present here. The legend inspired us to build a kind of cave like the one the dwarves of King Loden had, or to recreate the underground crystal palace mentioned in the tale. But it is clear, in this area, in this magnificent region, the architecture should not be the star. Nature itself remains the star, which is why the architecture is underground.
And
nature is our keyword. We are in a UNESCO Natural Heritage Site, and as such, it was very important for you to develop and implement something special in regards of the mobility concept. Exactly. Over the last years, we have been working on the development and the implementation of a new mobility concept, including the new Tirser aerial tramway, to ensure that the mountain plateau below the Rosengarten is accessible without a car and to make this offer available to our guests. One thing is clear. I have been enchanted by the Rosengarten region today.
And it is often the case that the captivating Rosengarten shows off its pink splendor in the twilight and keeps the memory of the unlucky King Loren and his rose garden alive.
And we're staying in South Tyrol and taking a look at another flagship project for tourism in this region. At Kronplatz, the newest ropeway technology meets innovative architecture.
Der perfekte Schwung, wenn wir von außen.
The perfect contour. When we talk about exceptional alpine architecture, we of course also have to pay the Kronplatz a visit. In addition to the Messner Mountain Museum Kronos, Olang also has another architectural highlight to offer. The roofs of the new station buildings of the Olang cable car seem to float. Hello, Mr. Pruger.
Hello, Stefan.
Wow, skiing is really the best.
I can believe that with this weather.
It's an absolute dream. I've already had a look at the architecture here. Why did you choose such special architecture at the station buildings?
The idea came about in 2015 when we built the Messner Mountain Museum. After the construction and the opening, the feedback was so positive that we felt inspired and thought, why not do the same with the ropeways too? In 2018, we organized an architectural competition, and we could win the Studio Schlattauer Matthiessen from Hamburg for this project. Mr. Schlattauer is a former senior architect from Zaha Hadid's team and had considerable involvement with the Messner Mountain Museum.
When I hear you speak, I can sense your enthusiasm, and the guests also experience a wow effect.
Exactly, the wow effect. Your eyes also take in the skiing experience, and uniqueness is what's most important for us. Skiing is the core product, and that's why our guests come to the Kronplatz. Art and culture are a secondary product and are particularly popular in summer, but are gaining in significance in winter too. There are plenty of ski resorts with ideally prepared slopes and modern ropeway facilities, but the Kronplatz has always focused on unique projects.
Your eyes may take in the skiing experience, but the same also applies to food. So now we will try some great food. I have heard that the architect from Hamburg is on the line, so I'm handing over to you, Karina.
That's right, Stefan. I'm connected to the Studio Schlottauer Matthiessen right now. Hello to Germany.
Yeah, hello.
Hello to Tyrol from the beautiful Elbe.
How did the idea of the floating roof come about?
We are fascinated by the technology incorporated into a cable car and want to show off this technology. We saw it as our task to make more out of these stations, which harbor great design potential. Not just using the most effective and efficient way to encompass the technology, but also to understand that this shell can also be used to create an experience through design expression.
Can the architecture of a ropeway station also set new standards when it comes to functionality?
The more at home visitors feel in the architecture, the more the skiing experience is enhanced. For us, it is not just the external appearance which counts, but also entering the building and the spatial experience. Altogether, this enhances the skiing experience.
Can we see a new trend here? Is it maybe more important today than it used to be to make ropeway stations architecturally unique?
A building should not sit in nature like a UFO and stand out a mile. Rather, our philosophy is to select landscape elements from nature and incorporate them into our architecture.
Thanks to Hamburg. And until such architectural masterpieces are installed, numerous steps have to be run through. Stefan, everything starts at the headquarter of Doppelmayr in Wolfurt.
Here entstehen sie.
It's right here where exceptional ideas become magnificent projects. Today, it's not about snow, but rather flowers.
Heute geht's Blumen. Hallo Nadine.
Hello Nadine.
Hello.
I've brought you something related to your work in the broadest sense.
Thanks. Yes, that's true. At the moment, I have a lot to do with flowers in the broadest sense. In 2022, the International Horticultural Exhibition is taking place in Almere, in the Netherlands. And in line with the motto of growing green cities, the organizers of the Floriade have installed a cable car from Doppelmayr as a sustainable means of transport within the exhibition area. And the special thing, the cable car will be dismantled at the end of the exhibition and will be reused on another site, namely the German National Garden Show in Mannheim in 2023.
How much effort does it take to plan green mobility for the Floriade exhibition and then the German National Garden Show in Mannheim?
Auch bei der Puga in Mannheim.
Various tasks need to be clarified and discussed with the authorities in advance. E.g., in the case of the Floriade expedition, the rope pulling over the motorway, or the construction and assembly of the station on the water. In Mannheim, too, there are various issues such as crossing railway lines, mounting aviation signaling devices on the supports, and the environmental and nature measures. The issue of accessibility is also important in planning to ensure that everyone can travel on the cable car, hassle-free during operation.
What are the most outstanding ideas and projects Doppelmayr has implemented to date?
There are quite a few, such as the Cabriobahn on the Stanzerhorn. This is a cable car with two levels, and people on the top level are transported without a roof, like being in a convertible. And there are also cabins which spin on their own axis. Or in Finland, there's a cable car with a sauna cabin. There are virtually no limits to the creativity. If you fancy it, come with us to the opening of the Floriade in Almere.
That would be really great. I would love to, and I know my colleague probably would too. Carina, let's take some time to join them in the Netherlands.
Thanks, Stefan. We're definitely part of it. But first, we're going to Norway and to another breathtaking UNESCO World Heritage. We're connecting to Bergen and to Mikael Sletten, the manager of the Ulriksbanen.
Hello, Carina. Thank you. Welcome to Norway. We are now in the Ulriken Gondola, heading up to Mount Ulriken, the tallest mountain surrounding the city of Bergen. The brand new Ulriken cable car and a renewed skyscraper and restaurant reopened in the spring of 2021 with Norway's largest gondolas.
With triple capacity on a cable car and a brand new restaurant on the mountaintop, we are proud to offer an all-year-round operation. From the cable car and the plateau on top, you have an amazing view of the city surrounded by mountains, fjords, lakes and coastal landscape.
On the mountaintop, we have a beautiful hiking area for short and longer walks, including the Sherpa stone stairs, finished in 2019, which is where I'm standing right now, on the very top.
Our operation is in a beautiful location, and we are very excited for the future to come.
And from the top of Mount Ulrikan, with this beautiful view, back to you, Karina, and back to Austria.
Thanks to Norway, and what a view we have today here in Sölden. Now we're going to the United States to our colleague Sean Marquardt from Doppelmayr USA that you might remember from our last show. And this time Sean has made his way to the beautiful state of Montana.
Thank you, Karina, and greetings from Big Sky, Montana. Stephen Kircher is a real visionary in the US ski market, and he's also a Doppelmayr ambassador. Stephen, could you tell us a little bit about the history of your company, Boyne Resorts?
Well, my father started the company in 1948, so it's a family company, and we've been the longest running ski company, I believe, in the world since then. Same ownership group, and have become the third largest ski company in North America with 10 resorts and almost about 4 million skier visits in the winter period.
Can you share some of your first impressions about those new D-line chairlifts?
Well, first, they're transformational visually and experientially. When you arrive in our base area now, there's two D-lines coming out of our base, and it creates an entirely different image, a futuristic image of what can be possible with lift technology, from the big screens that are informing our guests of what's going on, what's new, and what lifts are open and what runs are groomed, to the comfort of the lifts that with the blue bubbles and the heated seats and the quietness of them. I mean, they're incredibly elegant solutions for a base area where you don't want the rumble of the motors of the old technology. I liken these to the iPhone. It's people who saw the iPhone for the first time saw the future, and the D-lines are the future of lifts today.
We're also here on a very important day with a big announcement. Something big is coming. I think we should head outside.
So we're here in front of what we call the big screen on Ram Charger 8, and we're here to unveil the next chapter in the future vision of Big Sky.
We're trying to elevate North American skiing here in Montana at Big Sky Resort and elsewhere in bringing world-class architecture to our installations. And our next step at Big Sky is probably the most significant in that vein, architecturally, from the R2 terminals of the gondola to our mid-station complex to the top of the gondola and a base of a new tram. It's going to be truly world-class architecture, and we're excited about unleashing that level on North American skiing, and hopefully, as they do in the Alps, they really embrace it and react in a positive way. It's exciting to merge the D-line technology and the aesthetics of the D-line, both gondola and lift systems, with great architecture.
Thanks to the United States. Now back to you, Stefan, because you took a look around at where the chairs are initially manufactured.
A Richtig, Karina. Nach den beeindruckenden Bildern, die wir...
Right, Karina. After the impressive images we have seen from Stephen Kircher in America, I have now arrived at Gastner-Stahlbau, where the chairs for the spectacular D-Line are produced. I would like to have a quick chat with the CEO, Mr. Lugauer. Mr. Lugauer, what does Gastner-Stahlbau produce? Being a steel construction company, we produce all kinds of steel parts here, starting with the tubular frames, which form the basis of every chair. We also make the restraining bars, the frames for the bubbles, as well as the PU components here at Gastner-Stahlbau. Over the last couple years, we have also expanded our knowledge in the field of polycarbonate processing, and now we make the bubbles ourselves too, in all sizes and colors. Unbelievable just how many products are made here at Gastner-Stahlbau. And that's exactly the reason why I'm heading to the production halls, because I want to get involved a bit myself. Let's see how it works. It's hard to imagine how many of these hanger arms have been bent into shape by Helmut during his 41 years at Gastner-Stahlbau. Every move is spot on, at least with him.
Zumindest bei ihm.
Under the strict supervision of Ali, we move on to the PU foam processing, polyurethane foam. A real tongue twister. 50 tons per year are processed here, predominantly for use in the plastic components of the chairs. Finally, it's on to the assembly line where the chairs are finished. Every step is computer monitored and corresponds to the strict safety regulations, as Gerhard explains. And here on the assembly line, the chairs are also given their individual looks. The production of the supports also is an area of expertise of the Doppelmayr Group.
Genau richtig, Stefan.
That's right, Stefan. Our steel constructions can be found across the globe. Our area of activity includes these tubular ropeway towers, lattice towers, and also special structures in the field of material transport solutions.
And now we will follow one of these towers to the Montafon Valley. And I will report back from there, Karina.
Very exciting, Stefan. In the meantime, we're taking a look at an extraordinary project in Mexico.
Hello from Mexico's Pacific Coast. Today I can introduce you to something very special, namely to a gondola that is not only the first D-line in Latin America, but also finds a completely new field of application. The new 8-seater SkyDream Parks gondola from Doppelmayr provides a special kind of mobility for the guests of the splendid Vidanta Nuevo Vallarta Resort. And that's what we are taking a look at now. The new 8-passenger SkyDream Parks gondola links the different hotspots of the future Dem Park with a modern hotel complex. The ropeway offers a fast, comfortable and scenic ride between the various hotspots within the resort, as well with the Vidanta World Dem Park, which is currently under construction.
Major focus was put on the architectural integration of the ropeway installation into the resort. The selected colors and materials ensure that the gondola blends in harmony with its surroundings. Brown tones and wood elements can be found in the stations as well in the cabins. During the trip, ambient lighting underneath the seat bends, background music, and sophisticated ventilation concept create a pleasant atmosphere. 7 VIP cabins for special occasion offer luxury with mini refrigerator, sound system, 24 inches monitor, and the LED display. The passengers themselves get to choose whatever the glass floor in the VIP cabin should be, transparent or opaque.
Featuring a Doppelmayr direct drive with three rings, a fully automatic parking system, and the proven recovery concept, this installation is really state of the art. From the Ropeway engineering perspective, the layout of the line is a novelty. The Ropeway has a total of 5 stations, from the beach to Vidanta World, 2 terminals and 3 intermediate stations. The entire route was implemented with just one rope loop. Norma, why did you choose a cable car as a means of transport?
The cable car is the ideal means of transport for a resort and Vidanta World. It is always our goal to provide the best experience for our guests. That is exactly what the D-Line offers, plus unparalleled comfort and luxury.
Luxury and comfort are good keywords. I will say back to you, Karina, because I would like to enjoy this fantastic atmosphere in this hotel a bit more.
Wow, that makes me want to go on holiday. And after Stefan was involved in the production of the pillars, he made his way to the Valliseraban in Montafon in Vorarlberg, where he spoke to the people in charge of installing those pillars. And I can tell you this, that's a real physical challenge for man and material.
I have to say, I am deeply impressed by what the Doppelmayr installation team has achieved here, and I feel somehow emotional because I was there when these supports were made. Matthias, what challenges did you experience here?
The biggest challenge was the terrain, as you can see in the background. Those lattice towers are not easy to install via helicopter. Everything has to be just planned perfectly, from the design and construction to the assembly concept. This requires a whole group of specialists working together. We pre-assembled the supports on the ground and then put everything in place with large helicopters. We had to fly 367 tons in total, as almost none of the towers could be installed by crane. It took over 800 minutes of flying time with a large helicopter, and an additional 270 minutes with a small helicopter to transport the tools to and from the site.
Pass on my greetings to your team. Really great work. I'm now meeting Peter Marco, and we'll chat about all the new developments here. Hello, Peter. I am really impressed. That's much more than just a ropeway station.
Thanks, Stefan. Great to see you. Yes, it's much more. We have created a meeting place with the Silvretta Park Montafon.
Peter, please show us the underlying creativity for Doppelmayr Insights.
I'd love to, Stefan. Stefan, we are now at the gastronomic centerpiece, the so-called market hall of the Silvretta Park Montafon. We offer regional cuisine, and later today there will be a party here. We have a coffee bar here, and as you can see, we have a wine bar, so a really multi-flexible gastronomy setting on site.
In addition to the fantastic furnishings, what really strikes me is that.
That's the wool of a Montafon stone sheep, an exotic animal which almost went extinct and is being bred again now. A very special breed with a great history. Now let me show you how we've created the shortest journeys for our guests. When guests arrive, there's the ski school on one side, and then out of the office, just a few steps to our ski rental service and our sports shop. One floor down, there are two more novelties and a world first. Let me show you. This is the largest e-charging garage in any ski resort. We have 50 charging stations and we can upgrade to 500 as the pipework is already in place. For us, it's important to think towards the future. Into the snow with E, we are prepared. From the garage, the shortest route, the nearest service, is the ski depot for our guests. Here at our ski depot, we have space for 2,000 equipment sets in the lockers. Guests can leave their equipment here with overnight heating, then come back in the morning with just their sneakers and then head off to the slopes. The electrically driven escalator takes you to the cable car. Also electrically driven, which then brings you up the mountain.
You are even emotional on the escalator. What really strikes me above all else is that this new Valizerabon cable car operates in the unmanned Auro mode.
Yes, it's the first Auro ropeway in Austria. We're glad that we made the right decision 2 years ago. We've now been fully operational for a season without any problems and are really happy that we made this groundbreaking decision.
Peter, what was the ultimate idea or the vision of you here in Silvretta Montafon?
It should be a meeting place. The majority of our guests arrive here. It is our most important theater installation, and all of our companies can be experienced here. Everything is just a few steps away from each other before the cable car takes you up the mountain.
And with this information in mind, we will now switch back to Karina, because you're with the architect of this year-round operating service.
That's right, Stefan. And now I'm sitting next to the man that not only created the station buildings for the Valizerabahn, but also this wonderful Ice Cube and the 007. Mr. Obermoser, those projects are very different.
Different projects, of course, because the functions differ completely. On the one hand, we face the problems of modern-day cable cars that require big capacities. And at the Ice Q, we face the challenge of minimizing the footprint of construction because we are building on permafrost. So the two projects are entirely different. The Ice Q is based on reflection, i.e. the landscape is reflected by the skin of the building. When it comes to the cable cars, we prefer to design lightweight constructions so that the technology can be experienced too. Ropeway technology is unbelievably complex, and we want to show off the thousands of wheels and moving parts of these modern installations.
Why should every ropeway operator think about the question how to make the station building architecturally unique?
I believe that's essential nowadays. Marketing is a very effective tool, and I can have marketing free of charge with such a special building. You can't do without architecture anymore. And I have to say, fortunately, there is a high density of constructions in the mountains, and they should be created and designed appropriately.
How does nature shape architecture and the other way around?
The exciting thing about cable car construction is that the landscape is always different and extrapolate from this. It's an interplay between varying factors. We work with a geologist and we collaborate with Doppelmayr, who provides substantial support during the design phase. Then we need to find the balance. What is absolutely essential and what is not needed? This interaction in nature does not take place to the same extent with valley-based designs, and this makes it all the more exciting. And above all, it is always a new challenge.
Thank you, Mr. Obermoser. Apart from the architectural highlights, the Doppelmayr Group is also known for the highest security, constant availability and best comfort. In Dornbirn, the Doppelmayr Group has established a training center that's also open to international clients at all times.
I would like to wish you a warm welcome. Today, we are at the Doppelmayr Company's training center in Dornbirn.
Yes, Karina. Today, I am at the Ropeway Training Center, and I'm taking part in a training program with one of the trainers from Doppelmayr, namely Martin Herfalter.
Martin Herfalter.
Martin, what topics are you focusing on here with your team at the training center?
Working with the partner company, we have developed training modules which cover all specialist fields relating to cable cars. We can cover courses for beginners through to in-depth experts. We are happy to incorporate any specific requirements of training participants and can adapt modules accordingly.
Theory is important, but the great advantage is it can also be applied extensively in practical scenarios here.
We have training materials for all components here which can be used to practice how to use the components, how to correctly dismantle them, and how to resolve any errors which may occur.
What are the benefits of training on-site here in Dornbirn?
Participants develop personal connections with the trainers and quickly get to know one another. We have the advantage of being able to incorporate all requirements and answer any questions.
And sometimes you take your entire training team to the site of the customer?
Yes, of course. It makes a lot of sense to go to the customer, especially abroad, where we can provide our participants with basic knowledge. We also have the opportunity to train on-site and further develop expertise with our training container.
So what does a typical training day look like here in Dornbirn?
Depending on the training module, we start with some theory in the morning and then switch to practice by, for example, dismantling a grip or sorting and identifying any errors with our Doppelmayr Connect control system. This is always well received by participants. After the training, we give a tour of the factory and then have dinner together.
And so we say goodbye to Dornbirn and return to Sölden.
In the meantime, Stefan traveled to another architectural masterpiece. This time, he went to Salzburgerland.
Karina, what do you think of my carriage?
Stefan, you look absolutely amazing, as always.
Danke, Karina.
Thanks, Karina. I'm sure you have already guessed that today is all about Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, or rather, an ultra-modern cable car named after him at the Snow Space Salzburg. Wolfgang Hettiger is here with me. Tell us about this carriage, Mr. Hettiger.
This is really the digital counterpart of what we had back then. We are sitting in a carriage equipped with an interior like that of the past, but pulled by a Doppelmayr cable instead of horses.
This ultra-modern cable car also has other gondolas, which are also high-tech, you could say.
We have put special focus on digitization, and on the other hand, on the convenience for our guests. Firstly, these are big panorama cabins with large glass panels which offer views of the magnificent mountains at the heart of Salzburgerland. And secondly, the guest experience matters. Skiing is about emotion and passion, and here you can see all of that. We have a seat recognition system so that customers at the middle station know how much space is available in each cabin. All of them are equipped with Wi-Fi and heated seats. And a key theme, of course, is easy access. At the stations, there are four cabins at the same time, waiting for passengers to board. We are a family ski resort, and so we ensure that everything is easy for families to organize. with easy and convenient access to an altitude of 2,000 meters, Flying Mozart.
Fliegend, Flying Mozart.
The immediate station is the heart of this cable car, and it is there that we are meeting the architect, Ernst Hasenauer.
Here, the main challenge was to overcome the problems of transport and difference in altitude. The G-Link aerial tramway arrives at this point, but only just. Originally, the intermediate station was located 30 meters higher, and this height difference was not ideal for guests. We worked intensively on a solution, and the solution we applied here involves the second point. Namely, integrating large structures as much into the mountain as possible and building them into the slope to give the space back to nature.
In den Hang einzubauen und so der Natur wieder zurückzugeben.
You really are an expert, if I must say so, because your architecture studio was also responsible for the legendary Zugspitzbahn in Garmisch.
The Zugspitzbahn was a very exciting project for us. The main challenge for us was, of course, to redesign the top station. You have to envisage creating a lot of space and volume on a narrow mountain ridge. That's not so easy, especially when dealing with ropeway technology, geology, statics, etc. And I think we created a very exciting project there, along with the client. Where else in Europe is there a mountain restaurant at almost 3,000 meters, which projects 35 meters into the north face and is made entirely from steel, glass, and concrete?
In Stahl, Glas und Beton realisiert wurde.
Mr. Hasenauer, thank you for the chat, and I will hand back now to Karina, because Karina, now it's time to keep our promise from the beginning of the program.
That's right. Let's remember when Stefan met the project manager Nadine Haas in the planning phase in Wolfurt. And a lot has happened since then. The ropeway has been put into full operation here at the World Exhibition of Horticulture in Almere. And now I'm meeting the designer of the station buildings, Albert Schuster. Hello, Mr. Schuster.
Hello, Karina.
The station building looks a lot like a boathouse. What is so special about the buildings here at the Floriade Ropeway?
Yeah, the special thing about the station is you glide into the station on top of the water. You get off on the wooden landing stage, which is also floating on top of the water. And above all that is the R2 roof, which consists of very large glazed elements where you have transparency and you have reflection, so the whole station roof is integrated very well into the surroundings.
Not only did you design the station building, you also won a highly endowed design prize.
That's right. We have the Omega 5 cabins here, which we developed together with Doppelmayr Garaventa, and we've made the design and won the Red Dot Design Award in the category Best of the Best, which is the highest category you can achieve in design worldwide.
Congrats on winning the prize again, and thank you, Mr. Schuster.
Thank you very much.
Every station building is different and unique. We've definitely learned this today. A long, interesting architectural journey is slowly coming to an end, and I'm very happy that today we can all be in Almere together. Stefan, where are you right now?
Karina, architecture is also my cue. That's why I am starting my sightseeing tour here in the city center of Almere. Almere is a mecca for architecture lovers. The Dutch star architect Rem Koolhaas designed the center on three floors. Below are car parks and streets. Escalators lead to shopping malls and breathtaking residential towers. Above, on the green roofs of the shops, there are terraced houses with idyllic gardens. And Almere is growing. From the city beach, you can already see the contours of the newest neighborhood, an enticing green jungle called Hortus, which translates as the garden. But before the new residents move in, around 2 million visitors are expected on the Floriade grounds. And I am one of them. I am now looking forward to meeting Nadine Haas again and looking around the Floriade grounds with her. Nadine, how does it feel to sit in this gondola and admire the final product?
Seeing what we have achieved here is a really satisfying feeling. From the first steps until now, the completion. And everyone who visits our cable car here at the Floriade is happy, and that makes us proud.
I'm really looking forward to the Floriade now. I've done some research. 60 hectares are waiting for us, over 40 country presentations, a huge greenhouse, so I think we have a lot to see here.
Yes, I'm looking forward to it too. We have set up some panels to inform the visitors about the most important topics regarding this cable car. First, obstacles, like the motorway here, or rivers, can be flown over emission-free. The cable car is one of the safest means of transport, and it can be sustainably reused at another location in a relatively short time.
The Floriade exhibition is more than a colorful show of gardens from all over the world. It is an ideas fair for the future. We felt the way we did back when we were dumb and younger. How can our cities become more livable, greener, and more sustainable in the face of climate change? Keyword, growing green cities. And this is where Doppelmayr contributes with a cable car as an environmentally friendly means of transport of the future. Nadine, thank you. Now we have reached the end. Wow, this exhibition is really impressive. Thank you for everything. And Karina, I'm on my way to you now.
Hello, Stefan.
Hi, Karina.
First of all, thanks for all those wonderful insights you gave us throughout the show. And we're looking forward to meeting Thomas Pichler because he's also in Almere today. Hello, Thomas. Beautiful impressions here from the Floriade in Almere, but unfortunately, we already have to say goodbye.
Yeah, thank you, Karina, and thank you, Stefan. I'm really happy that we all meet here in Almere. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming along with us today. From the spectacular IceQ and 007 elements in Sölden to Montana, Mexico, and then the Netherlands. And here in Almere at the Floriade World Horticultural Show, we are proud of the fact that our gondola runs across the Floriade grounds. As an eco-friendly means of transport, whisper quiet and without any emissions. And with these wonderful images of the Floriade, we'd like to thank you, dear customers, friends, and business partners, and extends this virtual bouquet of flowers to you. We thank you for your trust and for the challenges you set us every day in terms of both technology and architectural design, up on mountain tops and in towns and cities. Your passion never ceases to impress us. You, dear customers, are bold and brave and visionary. You invest in your homeland, in your mountains, and in tourism. You are committed to the urban mobility of the future, to transport concepts that protect people and the environment, whether it's in garden paradise or at megacities. You are not afraid to think big and across generations, and we are proud to be working with people like you. I'm just as impressed with the performance of our people. It is only thanks to your dedication that these terrific projects are proving a success all over the world. I'm proud to have you on board and form a team with you. Stay bold and brave and visionary, but above all, stay healthy. And we look forward to seeing you again soon.